Atlanta, what an incredible city. I absolutely love Atlanta, Georgia. It was an amazing experience. I came there to see Tori Kelly live in concert, and boy, did she not disappoint. She was phenomenal, wonderful voice, great crowd. The city, I love the city, is very diverse, very energetic. There's a lot going on, and I like the fact that the roads are actually taken care of, which is a big plus with me. The traffic was a bit crazy at times, but I actually felt more comfortable driving in Atlanta than I did in a lot of rural areas in the mountains. So I actually love Atlanta. I love driving through the area. I love being around the people, and just I talked to everybody I could. I went to see Tori Kelly, and when I stood in line, I was talking to people. I met this couple, Ryan and Destiny. Destiny with a IE, not a Y. They were pretty cool people. I saw some band outside the line hustling for some money, but hey, I support anybody who's actually getting out there going after that money. But anyway, the opening act was phenomenal. They were wonderful. I think it was they were called the Third Story. Wonderful band. Look it up, the Third Story. Wonderful band. I met this lawyer, law student, Taylor, in line. Oh, actually, in the concert, in the building before Tori went on stage, and she was pretty cool too. I met her and her girlfriend, and we're talking about the apartments in the city, and I got a lot of good information. I just really enjoy talking to people. People were really, really friendly. Tori Kelly, once again, amazing voice. A lot of times you'll see artists on TV, but you don't really know how well they can really sing until you actually show up live, and she can sing live. She's a legitimate singer. She's wonderful. I love her music. I love her stage presence. The crowd was so into it. This one guy, the crowd was so energetic that even before the concert began, people were just singing along to the DJ's music. This one guy was just singing along. He was sitting up on the balcony, standing up on the balcony, dancing, and the crowd was cheering him on. And of course, when the concert began, the crowd was so loud. So everybody knew the lyrics to the songs. I was like, wow, this is incredible. I mean, but anyway, yeah, also, I went to the Georgia Aquarium. I also went to the Center for Civil Rights there in Atlanta, Georgia. But I also went to the aquarium. The aquarium was pretty awesome. I love the aquarium. It's so well organized and beautiful and clean. The dolphin show was pretty fun as well. All I could really show you is just, I just want to show you small parts of what was there, the whale shark. And man, it's wonderful. I don't know if I'm ever going to find an aquarium this good. I'm going to be hard pressed to find something quite like this. It's going to be tough, but I loved it. I absolutely love it. So if you happen to be in Atlanta, check that out. Where else did I go? Well, I went to the zoo as well, and I had a great time at the zoo. I'll give you guys some looks at the my experience at the zoo. It's a pretty good zoo. It was packed. Okay, it took me like a half an hour to find a parking spot, and then it took me about a half an hour to get out of the place. About a half an hour just to get out. I was like, "Whoa, get me out of here!" anyway, yeah, it was a lot of that. Like after the Tori Kelly concert, it was really, really hard for me to get out of the downtown area, but I mean, I was just pretty much stuck for a while, but once I got out of the area and got on the highway, it was a lot easier. The thing about Atlanta's highway is that even if you're used to driving slow, you really can't do it there. Like I'm used to driving 55 and the 55, but the speed limit there, a lot of times it say 55, but everybody's going 70 or 75. And then you got that one guy who's driving like 85 miles per hour, 90 miles per hour, and he's just zigzagging through traffic, trying to go over like three or four lanes just to get to the exit. Oh, man. Oh, freaking hilarious. Anyway, guys, this has been my Atlanta experience, and I hope to explore more of this great world. Maybe I'll go to New York this year. I definitely want to go to Australia and leave the country at some point next year. I want to see what's out there in this world. I don't understand how people can just be satisfied staying in one little place and have no interest in seeing the world. It's really bizarre to me. Maybe we would have a different world if people were more open to seeing the world around them. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.
Forward to it.
First time I've ever been to a strip club in Atlanta. So I've been to one in Indianapolis, but we'll see how this works out.
Still sunny.